Hey guys, Amos Johnson here, pastor of Church for Entrepreneurs. Just dropped the kids off at school and I'm recording my car so the audio may sound a little differently. Well, it definitely will sound a little differently. I want to give some additional reflections today about what took place in America last night. So for those who are not in the country, but you know, we had basically protesters storm the United States Capitol in protest of the election results of 2020. And, you know, tempers were flaring for probably 4 years, actually. You know, this is not just a random incident, right? You know, the Bible says God is not mocked. Whatever a man sows, that's what a man is going to reap. So the United States of America for the last 4 years, and maybe even before that, you know, we've sown a lot of division, a lot of strife. And this is the harvest of division and strife that comes out of a seed that's sown like that. And as I was looking at it last night, I wasn't shocked. And this morning, you know, God took me back to the scripture when Jesus said, as you get closer and closer to the time, said nations will rise against nations, kingdom will rise against kingdoms, there'll be famine and pestilence in diverse places. So Jesus relates this to like birth pains. It's like the closer you get to birth, the more and more these things are going to happen. Even though people are calling for unity, I know from a scriptural standpoint, unity is not prophesied for the world, but unity is prophesied for the church. So as a church, we got to ask ourselves the question, what are we going to do to participate in bringing about the unity that God wants within the body of Christ? As a unified body of Christ, then we can start seeing changes. As the light, as the world gets darker, the church should get brighter. So what is our part to play in that unity? And one of our parts to play in that unity is to begin the process of reconciliation within the body of Christ. On the election day last in November, you know, I really had a unrestness that was happening inside of my spirit. And it was so unrest. I was so grieved on election day that I literally just had to take a nap. It got an ambulance driving by. I hear the sounds of that. And as I was taking a nap, I had a vision. And at first, I thought it was just a regular dream. But as days went by, I realized that, no, this is an actual vision. Because I did forget it, right? That's usually when I kind of make the fine line. Like, if I don't forget it and it keeps nagging at me, it's probably a vision I need to pay attention to. So in this vision, I saw a leg, and the leg was green, like it was like gangrene or something, like it was like decaying. And then I saw a scalpel, and the scalpel cut open the flesh of the leg and pulled out a green disc that was green on the outside and white in the center. And when he pulled the green disc out, the leg was sewn back up and the leg began to heal. And I was trying to figure out, like, God, what does that mean? And so maybe a few days later, what came to me, what the revelation was for that dream, was that the leg represent the body of Christ. The green was bitterness. The body of Christ was decaying from bitterness. The scalpel was the word of God, because the word of God is sharper than any two-edged sword. So the scalpel went and did surgery in the body, and it removed the root of bitterness out of the body of Christ. And once the root of bitterness was removed from the body of Christ, the leg began to heal. And ever since I had that revelation, you know, I've really been thinking a lot about the unity of the body of Christ. You know, because when Jesus died, one of the things he prayed for the church was that we would unify and we would be as one as he and his Father are one. And that our unity will be a sign to the world that Jesus is real. And so what he was showing me through that dream was that unity requires a removing of the root of bitterness within the body of Christ. Not really bitterness against the world, because the world's not going to like us anyway. You know, Jesus already said that, you know, if you and me, the world's not going to like you. They're going to persecute you. They're not going to want you to exercise your Christian beliefs. So we got to kind of take that off the table. That's going to happen, right? But what we have control over And what Jesus really wanted from us is like, we got to look inwardly and start to remove these roots of bitterness. So, and you know, you guys listen from different countries, but I know in the United States of America, one of our biggest roots of bitterness in the body of Christ in America is the sin of slavery in America. The sin of slavery in America is at the heart, or really the founding root of most of the bitterness within the body of Christ. That's why we got white churches, black churches, because if we're honest with ourselves, you know, Christianity was used to justify slavery and use churches, you know, kind of sanction some of those Jim Crow laws that occurred in the United States of America. And while other believers were fighting against those things, some believers were fighting to keep the status quo. And that creates the root of bitterness, that creates bitterness, right? So that root, that sin, that's inside of the United States. That's inside of the body of Christ. That's why we got Christians who are Democrats and we got Christians who are Republicans. That's why Christians who are Democrats can't understand why Christians who are Republicans support Republican Party. And that's why Christians who are Republicans can't understand why Christians who are Democrats, why Christians can be Democrats, right? It's because it's that root of bitterness that's inside of the body of Christ that does not allow us to unify around issues that we actually see in common, but we just can't see it because we're in that root of bitterness. We created separate teams, right? And it's really not our fault for the people who are living right now in 2021. This occurred centuries ago, right? But we're living in the aftermath. Remember I said, God is not mocked. Whatever a man sows, a man's reap. And what the church has reaped in America is the root of bitterness within the body of Christ. You know, God is still for the church, of course, right? But, you know, his laws don't return void, right? So when God set up a law, like law of graft, you jump off a building, you're going to fall and break something, right? So if you sow a seed, you're going to reap some type of harvest on that seed. And so Jesus knew all of this stuff when he was leaving the planet. So that's why he prayed for unity. And one of the things that Satan fights the hardest against is a unified body of Christ. And what we saw yesterday in America was one more instance where Satan is creating a wedge in the body of Christ. All you got to do is take a quick look at Facebook or Twitter and look at the Christians fighting each other over this situation. Is they not really fighting the world? They fight each other over the situation, right? This is the biggest, not this is an event, but you know, this is Satan's biggest tactic. His biggest tactic is division. Because remember, Satan's kingdom was created out of division, right? He wanted to be like the Most High God. So he rebelled against God, him and one third of the angels, right? And so even with Adam and Eve, his whole job was to get Adam and Eve separated from God. And what God is trying to do is get us back to him as a unified whole. And what Satan is trying to do is trying to keep us separated and divided, because he knows a unified body of Christ is the full representation of the Godhead. But we got to get there. Now, I know it looks bleak sometimes. I know you're wondering like, man, how can it ever happen? But we got to lean on what the word says. If Jesus prayed for it, it's going to happen, right? If he prayed for unity, it's going to happen within the body of Christ. Also, we look in Ephesians. God said he gave some apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some teachers for the work of the ministry until, listen to this, until we come into the unity of the faith, right? So which means the unity of the faith is going to happen. So I want to encourage you guys as you listen to this message, don't be discouraged by what you're seeing. You know, yes, you know, I wish these things wouldn't happen, but remember, Jesus prophesied these things. But don't be discouraged, because Jesus also prophesied. He also prayed for unification of the body of Christ. As the world gets darker, we will get brighter. So in your prayer time, don't let the confusion start to get you off focus, what you're called to do. Stay focused, fight for focus, keep hearing, executing, and resting in what God is saying this year. And don't let Satan get the victory in the situation. Don't let Satan cause you to call your brothers and sisters out. publicly on social media. Don't let Satan get you to act in sin against God by downgrading or denigrating another brother in Christ. Don't let Satan get you to break with your brothers and sisters in Christ. Don't let Satan put you on the opposite side of unity. I'm not saying we got to condone sin. I'm not saying we can't condone activities and actions, but we got to check our hearts in this situation. And I got to check my heart too in the situation, right? You know, I'm human just like everybody else. You know, I have feelings, I have emotions, but then we got to go back to that word, that scalpel. That word is sharper than any two-edged sword, and it can remove that root of bitterness. It can remove it. So that's my thoughts, guys. I pray that you guys are having a great day. Keep focused, keep hearing, keep executing, keep relaxing. This is the year of rest.